So you've been using growth factors for pain medicine for quite some time.
Yes.
And you're using it for hair.
I'm using it for a lot of things. In fact, we have been using it for hair restoration. It's interesting because it not only regrows hair, but it goes back to its native state. And what I mean by that, if you put it in someone who's got some white hair, the new hair that comes back is the original color.
It's darker, is
it's
that
darker, right?
Right,
yeah.
Now we have a photo.
Yes.
Because I saw this photo. I said, we have to show this on the program. So this is somebody that went through
3 months of treatment, yeah. Once a month for 3 months.
Is that right? I mean, this is pretty amazing, actually.
Right.
And it's changing your business. So now that this, because look, you're dealing in pain all day, but people are going to start saying, could you treat my scalp?
They
right?
do.
Because everybody wants more hair.
Right.
Maybe not you, but most people do. So you haven't had to use them in your hair.
No.
Very thick. But if you were losing your hair, you would do it?
I wouldn't hesitate.
What about your buddies? Everybody has friends that have a receding hairline.
Right. So I have a close friend that is the CEO of a large company. He's actually younger than me. He's in his mid-40s. And he is the face of the company. He's Italian guy. He's in great shape. And he was losing his hair. He had significant baldness. And he underwent the therapy. And now it's imperceptible. You would never know. He has as much hair as I do.
Okay. Now, I guess what you're injecting in there head is different than PRP.
Yes.
And I wanted to ask you about that because I see a lot of people on Facebook and on Instagram, they're talking about PRP, and of course my hair's line is receding, so I'm looking at stuff like
right.
this. What are your thoughts on PRP?
So why would you have a procedure with something that has 1/100th or 1/10,000th the potency of these regenerative growth factors?
Okay.
You know, we talked about stem cell therapy, so-called stem cell therapy, regenerative therapy earlier, and using what we used to do in the days, we take your fat or your bone marrow. Well, we're taking it for somebody who's old. So it's old growth factors, right? So PRP, that's even less potent. You're taking blood and extracting some growth factors in very low concentrations, again, from someone who's old. Why would I use old growth factors? Why wouldn't I use new growth factors?
So you're using new growth factors to get the kind of results that we saw in that photo?
From amniotic-derived sources, absolutely.
So this can be a big part of your business.
I think so, yeah. I mean, it's starting to explode. Why do we have to go bald? Why do we have to age? I'm not saying that this is going to cure death, by no means. But my goal, for myself personally as well, as I get older, is to be able to do the things when I'm 90 that I do now, or that I did 10 years ago. Restoration of function and reduction of pain. And why do I have to look 90 when I'm 90? Why can't I look 60?